Well, good evening. Pastor John here. I'm so glad you're joining us online today for our hymn sing. We had set aside a special time last month to sing together some hymns on a Sunday evening, but due to our current need to social distance, we had to postpone this gathering. So we decided to be creative in how we could share this time of worship with you tonight. I'm here today with some folks from our worship team. We have Sharon on the keys. We have JJ on the drums. And I have Chris and my lovely wife singing vocals today with me. Here at Mount Pisgah, we are a multi-generational congregation that loves to sing old and new hymns and songs that just exalt the greatness of our God. Now, if you've ever been to a hymn sing, you know that there's one thing that makes it unique, and it's that it's not like a concert, but a great worship experience where all those in the church sing about the beauty of the Lord by lifting up their voices together. And as you can imagine, it's going to feel a bit different because we're singing without you today. But I want to encourage you and me and us on the stage here today to remember that the one to whom we sing still hears the praises that come from our heart. And so I want to invite you to sing with all your heart, with all your soul, with all your mind, and with all your strength today as you are gathered in your home, or maybe you're listening to this driving down the road, or maybe you're at work and you've just got some free time. But wherever you may be today, I invite you to sing with us. Let's sing our first hymn, He Keeps Me Singing, number 148. On the first.
There's within my heart a melody. Jesus whispers sweet and low. Fear not, I am with thee. Peace be still in of all thy ebb and flow. Jesus, 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 sweetest name I know. Fills my every longing, keeps me singing as I go.
On the second.
All my life was wrecked by sin and strife. Discord filled my heart with pain. Jesus swept across the broken strings, stemmed the stumbling chords again.
Sing it out.
Jesus, 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 sweetest name I know. Soon he's coming back to welcome me far beyond the starry sky. I shall wing my flight to worlds unknown. I shall reign with him on high. Jesus, 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 sweetest name I know.
Pretty good for a warm-up, guys. Good job. Our next one's going to be one that you know, number 269, He Lives. I serve a risen.
I serve a risen Savior. He's in the world today. I know that He is living, whatever men may say. I see His hand of mercy, I hear His voice of cheer, and just the time I need Him, He's always near.
Sing it out.
He lives, Christ Jesus lives today. He walks with me and talks with me along life's narrow way. He lives, salvation to impart. You ask me how I know He lives. He lives within my heart.
On the second.
In all the world around me, I see His loving care. And though Jesus lives today. He walks with me and talks with me along life's narrow way. He lives, salvation to sing eternal hallelujahs to Jesus Christ the King, the hope of all who seek Him, the help of all who find. None other is so lovely, so good and kind. He lives, Christ Jesus lives today. He walks with me and talks with me along life's narrow way. He lives. Salvation to impart. You ask me how I know he lives within my heart.
All right. So today, since we weren't able to gather with you guys all in the room, and couldn't take requests from you, I asked some of the people on the worship team to share a little bit about, to pick a favorite hymn, and then to share about it. So first, we're going to ask Pastor Chris to share about his favorite hymn, and then we're going to sing it.
All right. Well, when John asked me what my favorite hymn was, it took me a few moments to think about that. I have so many hymns, but I was thinking about kind of like the time that we're in right now and what could go along with that. And so I want to share just a couple of words about this hymn, a great old hymn, Turn Your Eyes Upon Jesus. Turn Your Eyes Upon Jesus was written by Helen LaMelle. She was born to a Methodist minister and his wife in England, and they moved to the United States when she was 12 years old. The song was inspired by a tract that she was given that basically was from a missionary that was a missionary to Algeria. And in the tract, it said these words. It says, "Turn your soul's vision to Jesus and look at Him, and a strange dimness will come over all that is apart from Him." And I couldn't help but think that with all of the things that are going on in our world today, that everything that is so taking center and focus in our life, if we would just let that stuff go and we would let Jesus be the center, those things would become dim, and they would become strangely dim, as this song talks about. I did want to share a passage of scripture with you as we get ready to sing this song, and it comes from the book of Matthew, chapter 6. And I want to start reading in verse 31. And I just want you to think about the words to this song. Turn your eyes upon Jesus and look full in His wonderful face. When we think about this, therefore, do not be anxious, saying, "What shall we eat?" Or, "What shall we drink?" Or, "What shall we wear?" For the Gentiles seek after these things, and your heavenly Father knows that you need them. But seek first the kingdom of God and His righteousness, and all these things will be added to you. Therefore, do not be anxious about tomorrow, for tomorrow will be anxious for itself. Sufficient for the day is its own trouble. So, church, I want to encourage you with those words. Anxiousness will be anxious for itself. Let's turn our eyes to Jesus, and all the things in the world will become dim when we think about Him.
He passed and we follow him there. Over us no more hath dominion, for more than conquerors we are. Turn your eyes upon Jesus, look for
that just helps you keep it in perspective, just keeping our eyes on Jesus. Thanks for sharing that. Our next hymn that we're going to sing is Leaning on the Everlasting Arms, number 453. What a fellowship. Oh, we might have to pull out the hymn book then. What I did to try to make it easier for Miss Sharon is print all the, take copies of the pages to put them in there, but apparently I missed one or accidentally deleted it when I was fixing the page turn, so.
I already know it by heart, because it would be what key?
Exactly. G.
I got it.
Perfect. All right, here we go. What a fellowship.
What a fellowship, what a joy divine. What a peace is mine, leaning on the everlasting arms, leaning, leaning, safe and secure from all alarms, leaning, leaning, leaning on the everlasting arms.
On the second.
Sweet to walk in this pilgrim way, leaning on the everlasting arms. Oh, how bright the path grows from day to day, leaning on the everlasting arms, leaning, leaning, and safe and secure from all alarms. So near, leaning on the everlasting arms, leaning, I'm leaning, safe and secure from all alarms, leaning, leaning, leaning on the everlasting arms.
All right, well, Sherry, Now it's your turn to share about your favorite hymn.
Well, kind of like Chris, when he said pick your favorite, it just kind of went blank. I was like, ooh, where do I start? Because there's so many. But you know, there's such a rich tradition in my life with my family when it comes to hymns. You know, I grew up in a church that this is actually kind of how it looked a lot of the time. This is how we grew up doing hymns. I learned how to read an alto part out of a hymn book. And so there's just a lot of history there. But, you know, the thing for me is that, you know, growing up in the church, you know, for those that don't know my history, I thought I was saved, but as an adult realized that that was not the case. And so many of these hymns I knew in my head. I had them memorized. They were here, but they were not here. And so as I grew older and especially as an adult, has been able to take these songs that I knew from having parents in church that poured into me so much, but they just took on a whole new meaning for me. And one that really just was special to me, especially in the last, I'd say the last 3 or 4 years, it is Well With My Soul. You know, for those that don't know our story, we kind of went through a rough patch, and details are not necessary because we know we all go through rough patches, but it's amazing how God can take songs and hymns and things that we've known up here and just really use them in our hearts to give us solace and comfort. Particularly verses 1 and 2, just reading those, when peace like a river attendeth my way, when sorrows like sea billows roll, whatever my lot, whatever it may be, that has taught me to say, it is well with my soul. And I know that he really, through that trial that he brought me through and our family through, he did teach us that to say, you know, no matter what it is, no matter what he is bringing us through, it is well. So this has just been a special song.
Oh, if you want to.
Whatever you do, we'll do.
Sharon just asked if you can't hear if we're changing keys. So we'll do the first,
the
second.
Mercy of Sharon.
And we'll do a key change on the last. How about that?
Soul. And Lord,
All right. Our next one's going to be number 98. Number 98, Come Thou Fount of Every Blessing. Oh, it's my time to share about my favorite hymn. All right. Well, my favorite hymn is The Solid Rock, which is number 511. And the reason that this really is my favorite hymn is because it just reminds me that we have a foundation in Christ that's never going to fail. I feel like in my life, I haven't always had the ability just to trust people and to feel like that I've had people always to depend on. And so this hymn just means so much because, one, I don't bring anything to the table. Our hope in Christ is built on His righteousness. And that's exactly what this song says. But even then, sometimes in life, we wander away like we just sang in that last verse. And so like verse 2, it says, when darkness seems to hide His face, I rest on His unchanging grace. Oh, the grace that we need day by day. And this song just is a reminder of that, that He is never going to fail. You know, He found me, He healed me, He made me alive. Paul wrote in Philippians that, I am sure of this, that He who began a good work in you will bring it to completion at the day of Christ Jesus. So we don't need to fear. We don't need to be afraid, because if our hope is in Jesus, then we can be confident that He is going to take care of us. On this one, let's sing the first, the second, and the last.
Trust the sweetest frame, but wholly lean on Jesus' name. On Christ the solid rock I stand, all other ground is sinking sand. All other ground is sinking sand. When darkness seems to hide its face, I rest on His unchanging grace. In every high and stormy gale, my anchor holds within the veil. On Christ the solid rock I stand, all other ground is sinking sand. All other ground is sinking sand. shall come with trumpet sound. Oh, may I then in him be found, dressed in his righteousness alone. For blessed to stand before the throne, on Christ the solid rock I stand. All other ground is sinking sand. All other ground is sinking sand.
Amen. All right. 461. He hideth my soul in the cleft of the rock. It's a great hymn. Let's sing that together. We will sing the first, second, and fourth on this one. We have Miss Sharon. She's going to share about her favorite hymn, and then we're going to sing it.
Very well. I was looking forward to this, and like Chris, there's so many that could be my favorite, but what's been on my heart right this week is My Jesus, I Love Thee. And since I've been a child, at 9 years old, I asked Jesus to come into my heart. And at age 13, I gave him my whole life. I surrendered my whole life to him. And I remember learning to play this song when I was 9 years old. When I would go to church, my dad was the pastor, so that was a little bit of a plus. And he'd say, okay, Sharon, what song did you learn this week that we can sing? And this was the second song that I learned to play. It had a flat, so it was hard. So, My Jesus, I Love Thee. There's not much known about the poem that was written, except it was in 1964 by William Ralph Featherston. He attended a Methodist church in Montreal, and my grandmother was a Methodist, so that's cool. He was only 12 to 16 years old when he wrote this poem. And the only reason it became public is because he mailed the poem to his aunt in Los Angeles. And when she read it, she quickly sought the publication. It was several years after his death, at only age 27, that a gentleman from the Gordon College, which became Gordon Conwell Theological Seminary, added the melody. And he published it in his book of hymns, so, thus forever transforming this poem into a song. So during this time, the only thing that God can't buy or manufacture is your love and your worship to him. So use this song to sing to him about how much you love him. That's what he wants to hear, and it will bless all of us. Thank you.
For thee all the fire.
The next song that we have is, I think it says in our order, and you may have to get the hymn book for this one. I think it says, How Great Thou Art. But I really wanted to do Jesus is All the World to Me. One reason that stuck out to me is in the old Baptist hymn book, 475, if I remember it correctly, it used to be Victory in Jesus. And so when I turned in here, we've done that recently as a congregation. So I was trying to do some things that we haven't done. But this song stuck out to me, one, because of the number, but two, because it's just really an upbeat song that just tells us that He's our life, our joy. When I'm sad, we can go to Him. So let's sing, Jesus is All the World to Me. Perfect. This one is Sharon's favorites, too. Have one more song left, and this one's actually not in the hymn book. We're sneaking this one in. So, you know, hymns are not just things that we have in the hymn book, but it's actually the style of the song. It's kind of the verse, chorus, kind of strophic style. And this is a hymn that the choir had been preparing to sing for our Palm Sunday music. And so we are going to definitely get to do that music in the future when we can gather again together. We're going to have a big celebration and do all that music. But we wanted to go ahead and just introduce this song to you because it just really is just a powerful song that just exemplifies just what Jesus did for us. And so we're going to sing, The Blood of Jesus Speaks for Me. Thank you.
because Jesus speaks for me. Be still, my soul, redeeming love. Out of the dust of Calvary, His rising to the throne above. There is no vengeance in His cry. All it is finished fills the sky. Claim that I should die for my offense. I point him to that rugged frame where I found life at Christ's expense. See from his hands, his feet, his side, a fountain flowing deep and wide. Oh, with his
that you've had a great time with our online hymn sing. It's been a joy just to be able to sing through some of these songs that, being a multi-generational congregation, we kind of blended on Sunday mornings, but I'm glad that we had the opportunity to do this, and I hope that you enjoyed it. Let's pray before you leave us today online. Pastor Chris, will you pray for us?
God, we do thank you so much, God, that your Son's blood was shed for us, that you loved us so much that you were willing to send him to this earth. God, to live in this cruel, sinful world and to die a cruel sinner's death so that we could have the free gift of eternal life. God, thank you for the words of these songs that we sung today. Thank you for the encouragement that they have been. God, as we just talked about your gratefulness, your greatness, your faithfulness, your righteousness, God, and just the love that you have for us, Lord, help us to lean on the words to these songs. Help us to lean on your word during these times, God. And God, help us to turn our eyes on you and let the other things of this world become dim so that the brightness of you shines before all men. God, we love you and we praise you. It's in your gracious and loving heavenly name we pray. Amen.
What a fellowship, what a joy divine, leaning on the everlasting arms. What a blessedness, what a peace is mine, leaning on the everlasting arms.